Dr. Craig, I had a question about the resurrection body as it might relate to the mind-body problem.
Oh.
I am a reluctant dualist.
Yes.
And the resurrection, I think, ontology has always tripped me up. My question is, does a Christian, be he a dualist or a materialist, need to affirm a physical continuity between the crucified corpse of Jesus and the resurrection body of Jesus? Or is there room in orthodoxy for physical discontinuity?
Well, I wouldn't want to say that it's heretical, but I do think that when you examine what Paul teaches about the resurrection body in 1 Corinthians 15, it's very clear that he thinks that the resurrection body is a transformation of the earthly body so that there is historical continuity. For example, in 1 Corinthians 15, verses 42 and following, he says, "It is sown a perishable body, it is raised an imperishable body. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body." And then he goes on to say, in verse 53, "For this perishable must put on the imperishable, this mortal must put on immortality. When this perishable shall have put on the imperishable, and this mortal will have put on immortality, then will come about the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory." So the verbs and the pronouns that Paul is using there have reference to the earthly body, which is transformed into this powerful spiritual resurrection body. So I think that it's pretty convincing that Paul teaches and believes in the historical continuity of the earthly body with the resurrection body, insofar as there are any remains, as there were in Jesus' case, of course. Now, in the case of someone whose remains have been utterly vaporized and destroyed, the early rabbis dealt with questions like that, because belief in the resurrection is, of course, a Jewish belief as well. And what they said would be, in cases like that, God had the ability to create new material, ex nihilo, and that could be the stuff of the resurrection body. So that it is not as though the historical continuity from the earthly to the resurrection body is essential for the identity of the person who is raised. On the contrary, I would say that that personal identity is ensured by precisely the soul, which goes through an intermediate disembodied condition that Paul describes in 2 Corinthians 5 until it receives the new resurrection body. And if there are remains, say skeletal remains of the earthly body, I think Paul believes these will be the stuff out of which the resurrection body is made. But if there are no remains left, then new matter can be created, and it will nevertheless still be the person who is raised who died because of the continuity of the soul through the disembodied condition into a newly embodied state. So I think your dualism solves any problem that you might have about identity.